Hey y'all, happy Monday. So I know I said last week sometime, not last week, probably like two videos ago, that I was gonna do some you know, like some more like life changer tips or like personal development type videos that we can kind of like go over together about, you know, changing your mindset and just like preparing yourself overall for the business of just network marketing and being like a better you, right? So I'm gonna do that, and today I want to talk about why stores are so important. But before I do that, I just wanted to show you guys that I just went to the store. I said I was gonna do like a grocery haul, but then I thought about it. Like I really don't like, I don't buy that much at once, only because like I kind of eat the same thing over and over, and when I get vegetables and stuff, like I don't want to buy that in bulk. So I don't know if you guys have like a farmer's market by you, but if you do, it's way better to buy like your produce from there, because that's what I do. I buy my produce from there. It's way cheaper. Like all this I have right here, I pay like about $9 for, and I'm going to show you guys. And also, if you guys are like fasting or you have an issue with being hungry, like some of you guys say like I'm still hungry and stuff, like instead of you eating like a meal, maybe try like eating some fruit, like a bowl of fruit or something, and drink water. Drink water before you start eating, drink water while you're eating, and drink it after, and it kind of like helps fills you up too. And at the end of the day, like it's all a mind thing, you guys. Like, look, do you want to drop the 5 pounds or 8 pounds or 20 pounds or whatever, or do you want to eat the snack? I mean, it's just like that's really what it is. But just find certain things to fuel your body, and then you realize that you're not really that hungry. I know if I eat like healthier, I'm kind of more fulfilled than what I am if I eat like fattening. Like if I eat like a McDonald's burger or something, if I get a quarter pounder right now and I eat it, like I'll be hungry in like an hour and a half, 2 hours, versus if I eat something that's like really hearty, you know what I'm saying? So anyways, let me show you guys this. Hold on. Well, I got this. Okay, so this is what I'm probably going to have for dinner tonight. I had to get some more steak sauce, but I'm probably going to eat these ribeyes. So I'm going to do ribeyes with some shrimp or whatever, some like grilled shrimp on the side, some kind of way. And probably I'll have broccoli with the steak, I think. I'll probably make potatoes for my girlfriend, but I don't really think I want potatoes. Sometimes I eat them. I don't know. I just don't know. I got this watermelon too from the store, and the only reason I got these little two pieces of watermelon is because it's just me that's going to eat it. My girlfriend doesn't eat watermelon, and I don't like to get the big one because like I make a mess, and my daddy's not home to cut it for me. So yeah. I got my zucchini and squash because, you know, I like to have this as a side. If I have zucchini, squash, and mushrooms, and onions, then I'm just like good. You know what I'm saying? Like I'm good because I can eat that with anything. I just find like a protein to go with it. So from the farmer's market, I'm going to show you guys what I got, which I probably should have made this out already, but yeah. Let me see, I'm going to show you guys. So I got regular mango, which is this right here, and then I got honey mango. I tried these for the first time last week. I actually like them, but they're kind of expensive because I believe it was 99 cents a piece, which to me is kind of high. I don't know. But yeah, I got oranges because I always get a navel orange. If I don't eat anything else in the morning, if I don't eat like a bowl of fruit in the morning with my breakfast, like I always eat an orange. Like I always eat an orange. I eat an orange, I take my NutriBurst, and then you know that just be my life. But yeah, so I got the oranges. I got one big mango because mangoes are like $2 for $3 too. Like mangoes are high, but I don't never like to get too many because I'd be so afraid that they're not going to be like fresh or something. And so I don't know, I'd be so scared. So I also got some peaches, and this is the yellow peach, I believe. I don't think it's the white one. I think it's the yellow peach. So yeah, that's the yellow peach. Got those. And then these are fairly kind of softish, so I don't like to smush them in the bottom of the bowl. But I also have some kiwi. Now for kiwi, I try to eat this in like a day because I only get like 3 of them at a time. So I try to eat them like the very next day or tonight or something so I can get rid of them, because they, you know, they'll go bad really quick and I don't like to chance it. But yeah, I'm really the only one who eats these vegetables. Like my girlfriend will eat something from time to time, but she don't really be worrying about it. You know what I'm saying? So yeah, I normally get her bananas because I don't eat bananas. But if you eat bananas, bananas is like a really good thing to get because bananas are, they're like really cheap. Like I wish I liked bananas, but I just can't tolerate the taste. Like I don't like the way, I don't like the consistency of it, and I'm not a fan of the flavor. Yeah, the closest I can eat a banana is like a annihilator, and that's hard. It's not mushy and soft and white. Ugh, I don't know. Anyways, I got one tomato because that's another thing. Like if I feel like having something that's like kind of like salty or something like that, I'll do a tomato. And I'll do a tomato, which tomato's not salty sweet, but you know what I'm saying. A tomato, and I'll do a cucumber, but I'll put like, I don't know, salt, pepper, maybe seasonal, maybe Italian dressing or vinegar. It just depends on what mood I'm in. And yeah, like I'm not on like a low sodium diet or nothing. Like I do, you know, use salt. I use seasonal, and you know, I mean, I use that stuff, and like it's not hindering my weight loss, so I'm like, I'm okay with that. But I mean, if you don't want to use it, I mean, don't. You could just eat cucumber by itself, but I'd rather not do that. Yeah. So anyways, my bowl, I'm gonna cut this up because I'm gonna end up eating these, but my bowl looks really, really nice. Like, it's really good. So I buy my produce like once or twice a week, depending on how much I have. Like right now, this will probably, today is Monday, so this will probably last me until maybe Thursday or Friday, and then I just go back, you know, whenever it's done. I just don't get like a really lot of, you know, a whole bunch at one time. I think this cost me around $10 for this, which is pretty good. I mean, it's not bad, you know what I'm saying? So it works out. Yeah, so I just wanted to show you guys that. I'm gonna go ahead and pick this stuff up real quick and yeah, and grab some stuff. I gotta make a phone call real fast, and then I'll be back to talk to you guys about what we got going on this week. So I am currently fighting with the sunlight. I know I normally film at night, but I'm fighting with the sunlight, and yeah, so hopefully y'all can see me pretty good or whatever. I look a hot mess right now. Do y'all drink coffee all times a day? Like, I don't know why, but like I feel like drinking it. I don't know, and I'm drinking it, which is probably not a good thing because y'all, it's like 6 o'clock. Mm-hmm. Bless you, cupcake. It's 6 o'clock and I'm drinking coffee, but I don't know. I had wanted to get my little cup in or whatever because I just felt like it. And yeah, so I'm drinking coffee. So anyways, I actually wanted to talk about something else because I said earlier, I know I told you guys when I was showing you my groceries and stuff for what I was gonna cook and everything, I had said like I wanted to let you guys know to talk about like why, you know, learning other people's stories within TLC is important and critical to your business success. But as I was going through my little notebook, because you guys, like, I have, like, notebooks, like, full of stuff that I could talk about forever, you know, from me going through trainings, me taking, like, you know, going through seminars and all this other stuff. So, you know, for business and everything. So, with sales, so I have a lot of that. So, it's all a matter of, you know, what I should tell you first. Okay, and so, because I just got off the phone with someone who I met on here from YouTube, and we were talking about like social media and stuff and like management of social media, so I figured I should probably go ahead and do like, you know, have like a little, you know, like a little video on this, because this is something that will help. Oh, side note, my Nutriburst came in today. I'm so happy. Like, I got Nutriburst, you guys. I got Nutriburst. I'm so happy. It's only 3 bottles now, you know. I have like 4 more on the way, so yeah, hopefully I'll go ahead and I'll sell these anyway. These are for sale. Yeah, I actually need to put one of these in an ice box for me because I think I'm kind of low. Yeah, so anyways, so I figured I'll go ahead and talk about social media. I know before in like one of my little life changer type video tips, I had, you know, kind of mentioned social media a little bit, but right now I'm going to go a little bit in depth and just hit you with a few points that will probably actually help you. And now, I know before I told you guys, like, I'm just starting to post about TLC on social media. Not as far as social media, but as far as, like, Instagram go and stuff, I'm just starting to do that. Because before I had it in my mind, like, I wanted to just plan everything out and have, like, a certain thing. I just wanted to plan a certain way. And honestly, that right now for me is all out the window. I'm going to start, you know, I'm going to be on Instagram, I'm going to post, I'm going to do whatever, because like, I feel like me waiting and wasting time, I'm just losing out on money, because I just started posting, and I haven't even really like technically post on my page TLC, I kind of like tag TLC, you know, like tag Nutriburst, stuff like that, and so, and I had people message me, and I didn't make money off of it, so it's like, imagine if I did that like 2 months ago at this point, you know what I'm saying? So that's all a point of, you know, like, me when I'm preaching to other people, like, don't, you know, don't hold yourself back, you know what I'm saying? Like, do what you gotta do to make your coins or whatever. Like, I should be, you know, practicing what I preach as well. So from now on, like, I am gonna post on there too. I'm not gonna like wait and just be like, well, I need to just do this first and have this done and all this other stuff. Yeah, I'm not gonna do that. So I'm gonna post, and you guys will see what I mean by, you know, you post and then, you know, you be social and everything, and stuff is going to come full circle. Like, don't be hindered by followers. It's like I tell you guys all the time, I have a business, a hair business that I've had for a few years, and yeah, I mean, I might have like around 2,000 followers, but like, my followers don't equal my dollar signs, okay? I make way more money than with the followers that I have. And because of that business alone and, like, you know, me doing, like, the little coaching and stuff in between, don't you start, you know, I was able to quit my full-time job. You know what I'm saying? Like, I quit my job August of 2018, I believe. 2018. Yeah, August of 2018. If it's not 17, I don't know. That's a shame. It's been so long, and I'm so proud that it's been so long, because you guys, like, you don't understand how that feels to just, like, you know what I'm saying, quit your job and not have to, like, depend on that, like, every 2-week paycheck. But what I will tell you is that reality hit me when I did quit that job. It was like, okay, yeah, you got this amount right here, you know, that you have, and this is all you're gonna have if you don't make this damn business work. And that's basically why I had no choice but to make it work, because I know I didn't want to go sign up and go to someone else's job, you know what I'm saying? So yeah, so the first thing I would tell everyone, okay, I know we're in the, like, health and wellness, you know, type field or whatever, right? But with any business, you should know who your target audience is. The reason that you need to know who you want to target is because you can't sell to everyone. Like, you can't just say you can sell to everyone. We understand that our products, in particular with TLC, is basically products that everyone can use, as in, like, you know, probably like your whole family, you know what I'm saying, kids, cats, Nutriverse, and everything. But everyone is not going to actually pay for your product or be, like, attracted to you. You know what I'm saying? So what I would say is, you know, narrow down who you want to attract, because initially you can attract a certain group of people. You can attract a certain group of people, right? And their circle can end up coming towards you for something off of them, off of that interaction with them. Okay, so for example, like, I'm not trying to be confusing, but for example, so if you are like 21, 22, right? And, you know, you have on your page, you know what I'm saying, like, you playing, I don't know what 21 year olds listen to, because I'm still stuck in the 90s. But if you listen to, like, I guess, I don't know, NBA YoungBoy or Doja Cat or Nicki, I don't know, something like that, right? And when you taking your Nutriverse or whatever, you have that playing in the background, you know what I'm saying, and stuff like that. You take pictures with your bikinis on, you always have, like, a lot of type, you know, like, lifestyle type photos, and you kind of do, like, you know, Megan Thee Stallion type things and stuff like that. Like, and don't take this wrong. Like, I'm not saying nothing's wrong with this, okay? Just hear me out. Okay, so if you're doing that, chances are people that you're attracting are going to be around your age range, right? It's going to be, like, within, like, a you know, 5 to 6 year type age range that you're going to attract automatically just from the content that you're producing on your page alone. Now, when those people reach out to you and they get your products and they start showing their products, well, they might have family members that's in, like, another age group, you know, that want to get the products as well. And then that right there just, you know, allowed your product to be shown through someone else that's an entirely different age range that you didn't reach out to personally, but it got back to you full circle because of the person that you initially attracted. But this is the reason why you want to zone in and make sure you attract one, a certain type of person. If you are paying, like, if you have stuff on your page and you're, like, I mean, you got, like, I don't know, sexual memes, or you got certain things on your page, and you playing, like, yeah, I listen to trap music, but I'm not going to put trap music on my page because that's not what I want to attract, right? So if you listening to trap music on your page and, you know, you telling me that, well, I'm trying to attract, you know, like, you know, a 40 to 50 year old stay-at-home mom, or, like, a, you know, 35 to 50 or something like that, like, you're trying to attract older people, well, I just don't understand how. Like, because, you know, you can't put, you know, like, you can't play, like, back that ass up and expect somebody that's, like, 40 to be like, yeah. You know what I'm saying? Unless they're, like, you know, from the culture in New Orleans or something, you know, it's like, it's not really an age out there. You know, we all just get down to it. But not we, but you know what I'm saying. You know, you just get down to it. But just know who you want to actually, like, target your stuff to. When you have a story, hold on, you guys, hold on. Hello? Y'all know my phone. Y'all know the cat and my phone only ring whenever it's time for me to film. So where was I at?
Okay, yeah. So I was saying, okay, so know your customer, like know who you want to relate to. And most of the time when a product, like the products that we sell, you know exactly who you're talking to, because 9 times out of 10, your target audience, your ideal customer is going to be somebody that's a reflection of you. You know what I mean? Like, you'll have somebody who want, you know, you're probably like, okay, so like if, say you're like a 35-year-old single mom, and then, you know, you were introduced to TLC products. You know, initially you were introduced to it because you needed a change in your lifestyle. The benefit of the money that comes along with it was a bonus for you. So you was like, okay, I can lose me some weight, get back to my normal self, and make some money at the same time is the reason I did it. That was my pushing motivation. That was my stance. There are a lot of people within your market. They might not fall in, you know, exactly one age range, but the ones that are closer to your age range will appeal to you, and they will, you know, be attracted to you because, you know, y'all are the same people. You know, they probably, they understand how hard it is being a single parent. You know, they're actually, you know, like living the same life and probably have the same problems that you had when, you know, during that time, like whatever in your life happened and it shifted you that caused, whatever shifted you that caused you to, you know, basically give your yes. You know what I mean? And so you just want to know those type of things. Like, just know who you're talking to. Like, who are you trying to appeal to? I know for me, as far as most of my audience that I got, as far as like Instagram and stuff going Facebook, like I get a lot of males following me because I'm a female, right? Okay, so, and my followers don't read nothing. You know what I'm saying? So the people that want to purchase from me don't really read. So if I post it on a story, they will go ahead, you know, and message me and say stuff. But as long as I'm like writing stuff out, they're not really like into that. But that's okay. I still post. I still write my paragraph or whatever I want to say, because eventually the people that I want to come along, you know, they will come along. They will read it. You know what I'm saying? Because that's what I want as far as team building go. It's one thing to have a retail customer. It's a whole nother ball game to have a team. Like, you know, I want to attract quality people. I want to attract somebody that I know, you know, like if I give you something to read, I take my time out and like, you know, do this or do something for you that I feel like will help you tremendously. I want to make sure that you are actually going to, you know, read it. Like, you know, don't take my time for granted. Don't just assume I have nothing better to do than to help you and train you and help you be the best person that you can be. You know what I'm saying? So, yeah, so you want to make sure, I already hit on that, you want to make sure you know who you're talking to, you know what I'm saying? Like, who do you want to attract? Whatever you want is your thing, but you know, you just, if you kind of like, if you post what they say in like marketing all the time, I heard this in plenty marketing classes that I've taken, that if you talk to everyone, you're talking to no one, you know what I'm saying? So just think about that when you're actually doing something. Also, be intentional. The next thing I want to say, like, be intentional with your engagement and your posting, what you're doing. Don't automatically assume that everybody know what you're doing. This is a good point, because actually last night in one of the trainings that we had, one of the leaders in the training was saying, don't assume everybody know what you're doing already. Okay, and so this is a point that is actually there that I want to say. Intentional engagement, asking for advice, using like polls on Instagram, questions for engagement, you know, like, if you post and you say that I'm selling Nutriburst, I have this, you know, it makes me feel good, I take this daily, I do whatever, don't assume that because you say I take Nutriburst that somebody know what Nutriburst is. Although Total Life Changes is around, it's been around a very long time, there's a lot of clout around this right now, everybody don't know what it is. Just because they've seen it and they say Nutriburst, that don't mean they know what it is. You know what I'm saying? So always make a post as if the person have no idea who you are and they have no idea what this is. Like, they have no idea they don't know what detox tea is. They have no idea what Nutriburst is. You know, they don't know what Total Life Changes is. Okay, they don't know. So always make sure you have some kind of detailed message at the bottom. You know, like a little small paragraph or something that actually states what the product is. And always leave an open-ended, you know, question at the end. Like, if you have any questions, go ahead and message me, DM me, whatever the case may be, wherever you're talking to them at. You know what I'm saying? Also, whenever you do actually say something about a product and someone message you, don't ignore them. Like, don't sit right here and post 24/7 about a product, and then when somebody finally message you and they're like, well, how much it is, or what's this, or what's that, and then you automatically sit right there and you're like, you know, you read it and you're like, I'm gonna answer that later. And it's like, well, what you waiting on? Like, you've been waiting all this time for people to actually engage and ask you what you have, because you're in the business of sales. You're selling something. So you have to be willing to answer someone, okay? I'm not saying, you know, waste your time talking to somebody that's gonna ask you 59 questions, because at the end of the day, it don't require that much. You know what I'm saying? You're gonna ask about the product. I'm gonna give you this boom, 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 boom point. And then from there, you make a decision. I leave it in your court to make a decision. You either gonna buy the product, you're not gonna buy it, you're gonna think about it. Either way, I'm cool with all three, but what I will not do is give away an hour of my time talking to somebody that I know is bullshitting me around. I'm not gonna do that. You know what I'm saying? Because as humans, when we interact with people and we looking at a certain product and we want something in our life, like, we're gonna get it. We already have intentions on exactly what we want to do. Our intention is based on what your response is gonna be to us, okay? So I know that if I'm in the mall and I'm going to get this specific shoe or something like that, I already know in my mind exactly how much I want to pay for everything that I want. You know what I'm saying? Like, I know how much I want to pay for it. So whether I'm going to sit right there and, you know, go back and forth a couple times with the salesperson to see if they're going to bend on a price or something like that, you know, that's what I'm going to do. But I already know in my mind, no matter what they say, I already got a set price that I'm willing to pay, okay? So people know what they be wanting to pay and what they want to do. So don't waste your time, you know, saying that, well, I contacted like 10 people this past week and 8 of them told me get back with them when they get paid. No. So, you know, because I'm waiting on them 8, I'm not going to move on and contact 10 more. Hell no, don't do that. If them 8 still interested when they get paid, they're going to contact you because they already know what they want. You know what I'm saying? They're going to contact you. So don't waste your time on people, but at the same time, don't ignore someone. If somebody asks you something, you answer them. I answer questions all day long. I answer questions through this YouTube. I ask questions on Instagram. And then the crazy part is that most of these people, they already have the product. It's customers and it's IBOs. They already have the product. They didn't get it from me. I'm not the upline. But they still ask me a question. I answer it all day long. And I still don't ignore them because I know people don't like to be ignored, you guys. And honestly, for me, it don't really bother me to answer somebody's question because, you know, as long as you ask me in a good way, you know what I'm saying? Because, like, what I don't like is when, you know, somebody say, well, let me ask you this because the person that I signed up with is busy. Like, they don't have time. Like, don't assume because, you know, I have a smaller team and, you know, that I don't have, you know, a team of 5,000 people that I ain't busy. Like, because my time is still valuable. It might not be to you. You might not think that, you know what I'm saying, that I'm doing anything, but you know, I got shit going on. Like, I'm doing stuff. So for me to even stop and take out my time to even answer you is, you know, it's serious. Like, respect that. So y'all take that with you. If any of you do that now, like, you take that with you and you understand what I'm saying is that when you reach out to somebody that you're not signed up under, of course, you know, like I said, it's family oriented or whatever, you know what I'm saying? You ask questions and stuff like that. But when you reach out to somebody, don't let your first line be, my person ain't got time, so that's why I'm asking. Like, you know, don't say that. Don't say that because, like, you know, they don't have time. They real busy with their stuff. Like, you don't, like, don't devalue someone else's time, okay? Because, like, we all got shit to do. We not just sitting at home with our feet kicked up. If that was the case, I wouldn't be selling nothing. I'd be retired by now. You hear what I'm saying? So, yeah, just work on that. But, back to what I was saying, just making sure you share your content. You know, you're posting, you're sharing. Share your transformation as well as other people's transformations. You know what I'm saying? Like, share what you can. I know a lot of groups, you know, they have people that everybody posts and, you know, we all share each other pictures, which is perfectly fine. Make sure you incorporate your own story, though. Even if you're not comfortable just yet showing your actual picture online, but when you inboxing someone, you want to make it personable. So make sure that you actually share your picture with them in the inbox versus, you know, on your page if you don't want to. I mean, because as some people are just uncomfortable with that. You know what I'm saying? Just work on it. And because the ultimate goal is you want to show your transformation. Okay. Like, I tell you guys all the time, like, I don't care to post full body photos because I know that I have, like, males following me for the most part. You know what I'm saying? And for me, I have a really large breast. And the first thing you see when you look at a picture of me is breasts. You're going to see boobs. You ain't going to see shit else but boobs. And so that bothers me. You know what I'm saying? It's not necessarily, like, the weight. That bothers me. And so, you know, so it's just one of those things, you know, work on that. But make sure, like I said, you share with your customers. Because if I message people, like, they can, when I answer them and stuff, they can see my transformation because, you know, I can send them pictures. I do. And then, like, of course, I got YouTube where I show, you know, all the wrinkle dinkles and whatever else, you know, I got going on. Okay, so the next strategy I would say is to make sure you stay consistent. Consistency is key, okay? You want to be consistent. You want to be able to build like a trust factor within your audience. You know what I'm saying? So there's this one app that you can use that's going to go like kind of according to somewhat your engagement that you have on Instagram. It's called When to Post. So if you want to download that, you can do that. It'll give you like the three most optimal times a day that you should post for more engagement on your social media. Okay, so you can do that. It just kind of gives you a time of like when the most people are active and stuff like that. But you want to be consistent, whether you're posting 5, 4, 3, 6, 8 times a day. You want to be consistent with your posting. You want to make sure you're always posting. Like for me, I'm trying to get myself on a schedule to where 8 o'clock in the morning, I always put a post at 8 o'clock. I want to maybe put another post around 11. I want to do another one at 2. You know what I'm saying? Like, be intentional on when you want to post and always be consistent with posting. What's going to happen is certain people are going to constantly see and they're going to know. I have a good bit of people that follow me through like my hair page, because I always like post a quote on there, and I notice these people are not my customers, right? It's just people that only like the motivation post that I put on there. You know what I'm saying? And you start to realize that, you start to see that. But just be consistent, you know, be consistent about what you're doing. If you're going to sell the product, be consistent with selling it all the time. Don't make your page a salesy page to where like you constantly only thing you're doing is saying Nutriverse, T. Like, you could, once again, like I said before, you can express how you're feeling about something and how you had this great opportunity of a lifetime and everything without mentioning what the hell you're doing. Like, you'll make a nosy person be like, well, hey, what you doing? What you know, what's making you feel good? You know, why you losing weight? Stuff like that. Like, you can bait people in without actually stating what you're selling. That way you can kind of still incorporate what you got going on, but you're not necessarily selling it, if that makes sense. You know what I'm saying? So yeah, so just be consistent. Be clear on what kind of products you offer as well. You want to be clear about what it is, because like I said, not everybody know. Be clear on what it is, what it can do, what it won't do, what we not able to do. Don't be sitting right here saying you know, we're selling these you know, some vitamins that's gonna help you get rid of COVID. Don't do that, you guys. Y'all will get flagged. You know what I'm saying? From TLC. Don't do that. Don't, you know, mention any medical claims. Just leave that alone. And then also, when people message you and they're asking about the product, be honest about it. You know what I'm saying? Like, don't hype up something just for the sake of a sale, because it's gonna bite you in the butt. You know what I'm saying? Like, if you promise somebody buku energy or something from drinking Nutriverse or something like that, they're gonna come back to you and be like, well, I ain't getting no energy at all. You told me that I would get some energy, so therefore, you know. So what I was saying was, you know, don't sit right there and promise them something that it might not be the case. You know, the way one product affects you, it might not affect someone else. Okay, so like for me, when people ask me about Nutriverse and stuff, they're like, well, you get buku energy or something from it. And like, my thing is, I say no. And I made a post about that today, as a matter of fact, because I'm like, I don't get super duper energized from drinking Nutriverse. It's a liquid vitamin. I treat it as that. I'm putting nutrients and stuff in my body because that's what I'm supposed to do, right? When I was taking one a day, I didn't get energy from that shit either. So, you know, it's a vitamin. You know what I mean? I didn't get any energy from that. So, but, you know, and then you get the, well, why would you just go buy another vitamin that's cheaper, or buy one out of Walmart or something? Because I get paid to push this, okay? That's why. Period. I get paid to push it. I like the way it tastes. The end. Like, you know, and it's a liquid. I prefer liquid, and I actually like the way that one tastes. 98% absorption rate. That's what it is for me. Okay. The end. Like, I'm not about to sit right there and say it makes me do jumping jacks and makes me feel like I want to work out, because it don't. I still don't want to work out. You know what I'm saying? So like, just be clear on what you're selling, what you have. Resolution drops for me, like I said, people ask all the time, does it curb my appetite? Will I stop eating? No, it ain't gonna make you stop eating. I mean, just because it curbed your appetite don't mean that when you finally do get appetite, you can go eat 8 slices of pizza and you're still just gonna lose weight. It don't work that way, okay? So just be honest about it, be clear about it. If someone is ready to actually change their life and actually, like, you know, live healthier and do what they gotta do to drop weight or just to feel better, not be backed up, drinking the tea, whatever the case is, they will make the necessary changes to do it. So you telling them the honest, you know, you telling them the honest truth about it will not deter them from buying from you. They're either gonna buy it or they won't. They're either going to be motivated by it, they're going to be discouraged about it, but either way, that's not for you to decide. At the end of the day, you have a product, you are offering it, you're going to give them the facts that you can give from the best of your knowledge, and the end. You know, that's it. Like, don't, you know, we're not going to spend an 80-minute phone call, you know, expressing that, you know, you can eat, you know, 8 slices of pizza, 5 burgers, have some pasta, you know, some chocolate and ice cream and shit, and then drink, you know, 1 pack of this, and then, you know, you're going to lose weight. Like, we're not about to waste our time and do that. So stop telling people also that you could just do whatever you want. What I recommend is, when I'm talking to people, I just be like, listen, for me, this is what I do. You know, I eat within this little window because I like 10-minute fast because I'm just used to it. So, you know, I naturally do it at this point. I eat between 12 and 8. I walk 2 miles a day. That's basically what I do. I eat what I want, but for the most part, what I eat is not horrible. You know what I'm saying? And that's it. I try to eat low carb. That's what I tell them, you know. So either they're going to say, okay, yay, nay, whatever. So basically, just as a wrap up, you guys, it's just that, just know who you're talking to, be intent with your content, make sure you're actually speaking to people. If you want to build up your following organically, go comment on people pages. Go comment on people pages, you know, like go under certain blogs or whatever. Just be social. You're on social media, go be social, go like pictures, look up hashtags that is relevant to you. You know what I'm saying? Like, you want to have like community type centric hashtags that's relevant to you, what you think people be saying, that's, you know, that's like your age. Follow these hashtags. If you see different things that inspire you or whatever, save those tabs, put them in a little album on Instagram, so that way you can go back to them, look at them later. You can duplicate that, okay? You can duplicate it. Like, stop trying to think of new stuff to do when they have proven facts and ways that it already been done. You know, so if you see this person did this and lifestyle, did this, did that, and you see they get a lot of engagement around that, do the same thing. Take the same type of picture. It's okay. It's not against the law. You know what I'm saying? Like, do what you need to do to get you some quality content, and it don't have to be, you know, it don't have to be like that in depth where you gotta have like a high HD photo or something. Like, you guys just do what you can with what you have. You know what I'm saying? But just make it make sense and be clear on what you're doing. Okay? Don't have one little post with this and you're just like, yeah, click the link in a bio. Like, you have to do more than that. Okay? So just be intentional about what you have going on, stay consistent, and just follow the course. Eventually you will get what you desire, as long as you believe you are able to get it. Okay? As long as you believe you're able to get it, you will. If you keep saying, I will not get customers, I will not build a team, I will not do anything, just know that if that's the way you feel, that's what you will always get. I posted something today, as a matter of fact, which is from Tony Robbins, if I'm not mistaken, and I'm going to go ahead and close that out with this. If you do what you've always done, you'll get what you've always gotten. And that is just so much the truth. So if you always assume that, you know, you're not going to get anything from certain things, you always assume that you're not going to make it, then that's what's going to happen. You know what I mean? So just change your mindset, get yourself ready to even tap into what you're asking for. You know what I'm saying? Like, you're asking for more money, you're asking for a team, but are you in a position right now to actually lead one? Can you? Will you be able to? If 5 people tomorrow say, come on, I'm about to sign up with you, are you able to lead them? Can you help them achieve, you know, success within a company if you don't believe in your own self? That would be hard to do, right? Okay, so just work on yourself, you guys. Work on yourself. Hopefully this was helpful. I'll be back tomorrow with another video. And so until then, I'll see you guys. Hopefully I look a little better, y'all. My hair is tore up, but whatever. I'm still in my workout clothes and everything, but I'm going to make these steaks and stuff. Yeah, so I'll see you guys later.